cannot defeat me.
Hello there, welcome back to Dark Forces 2 Jedi Knight. This is the final level, the battle against Jerec. The level has changed a bit, as you can see. Big spires come out of the middle. The reason for that becomes evident later on. Jerec is a lot more controlled, I guess you can say, than Bok was. More reserved. Shoots the occasional lightning bolt at me. Chicken bait, okay. He will throw a destruction as well every now and again. That force lightning's a bit annoying. It is slowly draining my health. Okay, I got a few back to tanks saved up. Right, dodge that one. Dodged another one. And eventually, with Jerec. A lot of health, obviously. Might need to drop one of those now. He will eventually retreat once he takes enough damage. Or not. Just wants to get going. There you go, now he's retreating. I will let him go, just so we can see what happens. So he flies up top. He comes up here and he meditates. I don't know how much of his health he recovers doing this, if it's all of it or just part of it. But he does get to do that. And then he comes down to keep fighting, so whoa. There is a way to stop that though. These buttons do something. I'm not sure, to be honest, I'm not sure exactly what they do. But they do something. But that's Jerec anyway, so. Where's he gone? There he is. Please just try and take him out now. Move the lightning. Probably should try and save some force power. Drop a few backers and pick another one up. I can save up a destruction or two. When he tries to run, I can hit him with it. Talk about is there? I mean, just a sort of slow battle. It's all it is. Those Bactors seem to just try and run for it now. Oh, I got him just in time. No healing for you.
Our spies bring word of a small rebel uprising on Danuta.
I have no time for petty uprisings. Extinguish them painfully.
Yes, Emperor.
I want you to remember, son, when you're at the academy, how very proud I am of you.
And that is the end of Dark Forces 2 Jedi Knight, playing on the dark side of the Force. So as you see, Jerec is defeated, and then Kyle Katarn takes over the Empire with Saris by his side. The only real difference playing as the dark side compared to the light side, apart from the obvious of the Force powers, is that in that level afterwards where you survive the falling spaceship, at the dark side you fight Yun and finally finish him off, where Saris does not appear. Whereas if you play as the light side of the Force, you fight Saris straight away and kill her, leaving Yun's fate to be unknown. So you play as the dark side, you don't fight Saris, and she remains by your side at the end of the game when you become Emperor. That is the story part of it out of the way. I'd have to say this is probably one of my favourite childhood games. It came out in 1997, so I was only, 13 years old at that stage. And I did get the game as it got released. Not that I bought it, I actually won it in a radio contest, which is pretty cool. I just phoned up, gave my details, and a few weeks later had a parcel arrive with a brand new video game. So that's pretty exciting for a teenager back in those days. And then back in those days, I was running a Pentium 120 megahertz processor with, I think, an almighty 16 megabytes of RAM or around that mark. So quite unremarkable computers back in the day. I was running the game probably on 320 by 200 resolution in all its blocky goodness, but regardless of that, I still played it non-stop, and it was still definitely one of my favorite games of the generation. And even in hindsight, you look back at that, it is one of my favorite games I've played probably in my life, really. It's just a classic game that's always resonated with me quite well. I think it does Star Wars very well. It's got the sounds, it's got the sights, it's got the Force, it's got the Imperials. Like, it's got everything you need from a Star Wars game without going over the top or too far or gimme healing. It's just a classic game. So I guess without further ado, I'll just let the credits roll on as I always do with all my playthroughs. I think it's only fair that if I play the game, put it online like this, get enjoyment out of it, well, I should at least let the credits roll through so the people who are involved in production get their recognition in that little small way. I haven't decided what game I'm going to play next. I will continue the Dark Forces series. I've got to play Jedi Outcast once more as a Dark Jedi in that game. And we'll continue through to Jedi Academy. I've never actually finished that game. But I might do something in between just to mix up a bit, but we'll see what happens. So let's let the credits roll through, and I'm going to say one more time, thanks for watching, guys. I appreciate your support, and I hope to see you for my next series. Take care.